this ultimate poise, like I've been had it figured out. Nah, I just didn't quit. That's the only distinguishing quality from me and probably whoever else going through this or went through this or is gonna go through this, is that I ain't quit. I went through every emotion.
Dog, I ain't gonna lie to y'all, man. My ass got fired again.
Nigga!
I know what y'all thinking. Nigga, you should have never been back the second time. I know. It is what it is. I ain't gonna lie. I'm the reason why I got fired. And I'm gonna tell y'all why I got fired. To me, it's protocol. I guess it makes sense, but it don't make sense to me. In a way, it just don't make sense to me. But I'm gonna tell you why I got fired. So when it's raining, right? It's raining, it's thundering outside. When you get back to the station, you're not allowed to walk in the station to return your packages or to sign out so you can go home after, right? But the shit I don't understand is if we outside, you know, delivering the packages while it's raining and thundering, and the only thing they're gonna tell you is, oh, pull over so the rain can pass by or something like that. But if it's 3 hours going by and it's still raining, it's still ugly outside, no matter what, I still got to deliver the packages. You feel me? But when we get back to the station, it's like we can't walk inside the station while it's thundering and shit like that. Like I don't understand that shit at all. Like I just don't understand. So literally, I came back to the station. I had like 2 packages to return, and it was like I would say like there was probably over 10 people at the station before I got back there, and that some of them was already waiting there for like an hour and a half. You know what I mean? And I'm there for like a good 20 minutes. I'm like, bro, like I want to go home. Like I've been, you know, out delivering for the past 10 hours. You think I want to stay another hour? Like, even though I understand, yes, I'm getting paid to stay another hour, to stay in the van, but nigga, it's about to be 9:00. You think I want to stay my ass in the van, bro? Like, come on, man. What type of procedure is that? Like, y'all worried about our safety when it's raining and thundering outside, but when we out making our delivery, y'all ain't worried about shit. Y'all just worried about just making sure y'all deliver all that packages before 9:30. I fuck around and don't deliver 68 packages while it's still thundering and raining outside. You know what I mean? Like that, it just, in my mind, it don't make sense. But I understand it's fucking protocol. So I decided, you know, I was there for like a good 40 minutes, almost 40 minutes. I decided to say, fuck it, I'm going home, right? When I decided to go home, I still had 2 packages to bring back, and I had to sign out. Just because I left those packages inside the van, they decided, oh, well, we can't let you do that, so, you know, if you do it, we're gonna have to write you up, and that's gonna be your final written up. So I'm just like, okay, and you know, I walked in my car, I drove off. Now here's the flaw shit about Amazon. They had me, knowing that I was scheduled to come to work the next day, they had me drive to work, right? This is telling me, oh, I don't need to work today. And in my right mind, motherfuckers that got common sense would be like, let me call this dude before he make this drive. You know what I mean? Let me just call him before he make this drive. Nah, they didn't do that. They didn't do that. So when I got there, my sister pulled up. So I seen my sister pulled up. I'm like, she wasn't scheduled to come in at 9:30. So come to find out, they gave her my shift. So I was like, oh, okay. I see how y'all wanna do it. I see the flawness in this bitch. I said, okay. So like when I got there, it was like, oh, you know, you can call the manager. She said you don't have to come in today. If you have any questions, you can call her. I said, why do I need to call? Like, why do I? They told me I have to call. I'm like, why do I have to call her? You know what I mean? Like, what sense do that make? I don't need to call her. She can call me. You're the manager. I don't have to call you. It was your responsibility to tell me before I got to the station or to the offsite to not come to work. But you did it. So why the hell do I gotta call you to act to, for what? For what? I already got the news. Like, honestly, I already got the news. Like, why the hell I gotta call your... Let me not. I just don't understand. Like, why do I gotta call you? You know what I mean? So I didn't call her at all. I waited for the next thing for her to hit me back up. She still didn't hit me up. Come Friday, I think Thursday, that third day, I was off that day. But when it came to coming back to work on Friday, they hit me up before I even came to work. I said, oh, you don't gotta come in, but you gotta do report to work on Monday at 1:30. So when they telling me that, I'm like, yeah, I'm getting fired. I know I'm getting fired. You know what I mean? Because they just can't tell me straight up. They want me to sign a paper and shit. In my mind, I should have ran ahead and just wrote my 2 weeks notice. That's what I should have done. But I was like, it's Amazon did again. Like, I already got fired three times. I think three times is the final, all right, nigga, like, you, this job ain't shit type of shit. Like, I don't give a damn how good the money is. Bitch, no, you just don't treat people like that. You don't treat people like that. And the fact that they don't want to tell you up front that you getting fired, they pussies, okay? I'm gonna let y'all know right now, they pussies. They could have told you over the phone, you don't have to raise your goddamn gas to come over there. At all. But yeah, I got fired because I left two packages in the van and I didn't sign out. That's why I got fired. Literally, why I got fired. So, I could have stayed in the van for like another hour and get paid in the clock.
You still.
Nigga. Who wants to stay in a van for another hour unless you're getting high? Unless you're getting high. Literally. Unless you're getting high. Ain't gonna be me. I'm telling you. Ain't gonna be me. I'm sorry. Ain't gonna be me. Shit. Yeah, man. That's all I need to tell y'all, man. Because third time getting fired by Amazon. That shit crazy, dog. You would think that shit would hurt you, but it's to the point where, nigga, I'm numb to this shit. I'm just so numb. And I still end up getting like two paychecks from them after I got fired. So I'm just like, nigga, I can go another month and a half without having to go back to work. Literally, like I'm good right now. I'm chilling. I'm big chilling. So yeah, man, Amazon ain't shit. Y'all know this, man. Y'all know this. Y'all hear it from me all the time. Amazon ain't shit. I don't think they ever be shit. They won't ever be shit unless they change their protocol. Cause that protocol was fucking stupid. And I know what I did was fucking. Thank you. Yeah, I know. Yeah, so I gotta do what I gotta do. But you know, I had to let y'all know what's going on with my life right now, so. But I ain't stressing. The best thing in life, you don't want to stress about things that you can't have in your control at times. You know what I mean? You just live it up, move forward, and just enjoy every moment. Like, don't let nothing bring y'all down. I'm telling y'all, don't let nothing bring y'all down. Y'all strive for greatness. Don't stress. Do what y'all can to chase after y'all goal. Do anything y'all can to chase after y'all goal, all right? It's your boy, Old Lord, and I'm out. Love y'all, man.